Glory be to the Father. Of the tribes of the sons of Jacob, to whom the word of the Israel shall be your name. Then with the stones he built an altar in the name of the Lord. And he made a trench around the altar large enough to hold two sealed seeds. And he put the wood in order, cut the bull in pieces, and laid it on the wood and said, fill four water pots with water and pour it on the burnt sacrifice and on the wood. Then he said, do it a second time. And they did it a second time. And he said, do it a third time. And they did it a third time. So the water ran all around the altar, and he also filled the trench with water. And it came to pass at the time of the offering, the evening sacrifice, that Elijah the prophet came near and said, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known this day that you are God in Israel, and I am your servant, and that I have done all things, these things, at your word. Hear me, O Lord, hear me, that this people may know that you are the Lord God, and that you have turned their hearts back to you again. Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt sacrifice, and the wood, and the stone, and the dust, and it licked up the water that was in the trench. Now then all the people saw it, and they fell on their faces and said, the Lord, he is God, the Lord, he is God. Stand for the prayer of a
ourselves, that we should not trust in ourselves, but in God who raises the dead, who delivered us from so great a death, and does deliver us, in whom we trust that he will still deliver us, you also helping together in prayer for us, that thanks may be given by many persons on our behalf for the gift granted to us through many. For our boasting is this, the testimony of our conscience that we conducted ourselves in the world in simplicity and godly sincerity, not with fleshly wisdom, but by the grace of God, and more abundantly toward you. For we are not writing any other things to you than what you read or understand. Now I trust you will understand, even to the end, as also you have understood it us in part, that we are your boast, as you are also ours, in the day of the Lord Jesus. Glory be to the Lord of all.
Glory be to the Lord of all. Make us wise in your mind, save us with your knowledge. Sanctify us with your truth, and grant us to be obedient to your words, and to fulfill your commandments at all times, O Lord of all. Father and Son, and Holy Spirit, forever.
Depart in fear and anger upon
Glory be to Christ our Lord. Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed are my Lord,
blessed are my Lord, my brothers.
Church, by the grace of his compassion, forever. Amen.
May God, the Lord of all, be pleased with your sacrifice, and accept the oblation which you offer for us and for yourself, by the grace of his mercies, forever. Amen.
May God might grant them all at the resurrection from among the dead, and give us with them a good hope, a portion and an inheritance of life. Say, Lord, you may say, Lord, with confidence.
Amen. Bless our Lord.
May Christ confirm your words and accept the fruits of your lips, and may you exalt the debts and sins of all who listen to you.
Amen.
And may this salvation be accepted with confidence, and may it be sanctified by the word of God and by the Holy Spirit, that it may be a benefit to us and salvation and life forever and ever in the kingdom of heaven by the grace of Christ.
Listen, my Lord, listen, my Lord, listen, my Lord, my brothers, pray for me.
Christ, be your friends. May Christ receive your blessing, and may Christ adorn your priesthood in the kingdom of heaven, and may he be pleased with this sacrifice which you offer for yourself and for us and for the entire world, which looks for and awaits his grace and his mercy forever. Amen.
And with perfect love and with true faith, we make this the gift towards us.
Amen.
Bless our Lord. And we lift up to you praise, honor, thanksgiving, and worship you now and all times and forever.
Spirit with us all, now and at all times. for yourself and for us and for the entire world, which looks for and awaits with grace and his mercy forever. Amen.
And with the holy cherubim and the spiritual seraphim, offering worship to your Lordship.
Amen. Bless our Lord.
While praying and praising without ceasing, and calling one to another and saying,
you.
Thank you. Love us. Successful applicants will have their tuition fees covered as follows. For those in year 6 this year, they will have year 7 and year 8 fees paid for. For those in year 8 this year, will have years 9 and 10 covered. And for those in year 10 this year, will have years 11 and 12 covered. That is, if they meet the above requirements, being exceptional academic results, involvement, extracurricular activities, and community engagement. So for further information and application forms, you can visit the college website or from the college office Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. So the closing date is Friday the 20th of August, so you have just over a month to apply for it. Students have already applied, no need to apply. So this is for further applications. As we turn to this Sunday, beloved, the Friday that passed, we concluded the season of the apostles with the commemoration of the 72 apostles. And so today is a new season, the season of summer. But also, the first Sunday of summer is also celebrated as a minor feast called Musadda, which is translated as the Feast of God. But it is also the commemoration of the 12 apostles, and this year it coincides with the commemoration of Marius, the Carnation of Blessed Mary. So it's a very busy Sunday. Usually this Sunday is busy as enough, but because of Marius's commemoration, there's another celebration added to this Sunday. So we can't speak about all these things today, but I would like to focus today on the apostles. So this commemoration of them, as I said, it follows the 7 weeks of the season, but this Sunday is dedicated to them because it really celebrates their missionary work in remembrance of their preaching, their baptizing, their discipling. And so the season of summer begins with an acknowledgement of the fruits of their labors, which resulted in the flourishing of the Christian faith in the formative years of the early church. Hence, there is a tradition on this day that faithful members of the church, they sprinkle water on each other as a remembrance of the great many who are coming for baptism, who are being baptized by hearing the message, by being converted, by repenting and being baptized. And so you can sprinkle water at home in isolation today in remembrance of this celebration. So through this season, there is an emphasis on repentance throughout these 7 weeks. Since repentance became the natural response to those who heard the gospel and the gospel resonated within them, they naturally repented of their former ways and they came to the light and they were enlightened by baptism and they became now alive in Christ. But also, today signifies the triumph of Christianity over heresy, over error. In one of the stanzas of this morning's hymn of praise during the Matin service, we were singing, "Blessed is he who filled his apostles with the Spirit, and he sent them as preachers into the world, and by the light of their knowledge, they uprooted error from the nations which were in darkness." So we see the triumph of Christianity over the error, darkness that was in the world. They uprooted this error by the preaching of the true faith. That Jesus is Lord, that he has conquered death, and that he has promised eternal life to all those who believe and live a faithful life. But it is not only the 12 apostles who are mentioned in this type of work. In one of the liturgical anthems appointed today, which unfortunately we did not sing, but I still want to share with you what was assigned to this anthem. Today, it celebrates the work of the 318 fathers of Nicaea, who in the likeness of the 12 apostles, uprooted the error of the heresy, the heretics, who attempted to corrupt and plague the Christian faith in the 4th century, namely Arius. And so to recognize the major contribution of the Holy Apostles and these church fathers, which safeguarded the true faith, we want to turn our attention to one of the appointed lecture readings from today, which is from 1 Kings, which Shemash Ami read. 1 Kings, chapter 18. It's a short reading, it's only about 9 verses, but really, it's nestled in an overall picture of what's happening in the book of Kings, and really in the Elijah cycle. Elijah is not mentioned much in the book of Kings, a number of chapters. And so today we get a glimpse of what was happening at that time. And to bring us up to speed, because where the reading picks up from, unless we're very familiar with the Elijah story, we'll be lost, we don't know what's happening. But basically, for 3.5 years, Elijah, by the authority of the Lord, he called a drought over all Israel because King Ahab, one of the worst kings of Israel, we're told, he was one of the worst, if not the worst. He allowed his wife Jezebel to bring in the Baal worshippers, the idol worshippers, to pull down, to break down the altars of the Lord, and to allow her prophets and priests to come in. She had the prophets slain, killed. 100 of them were hidden by Obadiah, who came and he fed them. But this was happening in the land of Israel. And because of that, no more water was cut off. Now, it was no God didn't just arbitrarily say, let's see, it's not going to let rain come on the ground. No, there's a reason. Because the God they are worshipping Baal, he was meant to be the God of rain and of agriculture, fertility, of making a fertile ground. And so God showed who was God in the land of Israel by shutting up the heavens, by not allowing any rain to come down. And so this troubled Israel, and it troubled the king, and he had great resentment towards Elijah, and so did Jezebel. And so this is what's going on. He searched far and wide looking for Elijah to kill him, destroying the villages that he went and visited that said, we have not seen him. But the Lord kept Elijah safe in the wilderness, feeding him, bringing ravens, dropping food for him. He was drinking water by the brook until it dried out. Then he went and lived with a widow, who the Lord sustained with just a small jar of oil and flour. He sustained them day by day until the famine was gone, because drought, no agriculture, no crops brings famine. But God said, enough is enough. We need to end the drought. And he sent Elijah. He said, go. Today it will end. And Elijah went and he challenged the Baal worshippers. He says, today on Mount Carmel, on the place on high, we will show you who is the Lord God. And so there was an open challenge that the Baal worshippers would offer to their God, and then Elijah would offer to his God. And whoever's sacrifice was consumed by fire, that would be the real God. And the people consented, yes, this is good. And so Elijah allowed the Baal worshippers to go first. From morning all the way to noon until afternoon, late afternoon, they were calling and Baal was silent, nothing. Not a whisper. There was no fire consuming it. 450 Baal worshippers were there. There was only one man of God, Elijah, opposed to him. He called Israel as witnesses, come and watch. They were there watching because they had turned aside from God and been following Baal. And saying, look, this is the God you've been worshipping. And he said, enough. Now let me call upon my God. And so he really showed much disadvantages. He really gave a lot of advantage to the Baal worshippers. 450 verse 1. But then he said, let me show you what I'm going to do. He now presented his sacrifice. But before he done that, the reading today tells us that he first repaired the altar of the Lord. The altar in which had been used to offer sacrifices before the Baal worshippers, now he was repairing it because it had been torn down, broken by the Baal prophets. And how did he repair this? He repaired this by taking 12 stones and fixing the altar. And he said, as he's doing this, as I'm doing this, so shall your name be Israel to the people. He was reminding them of the covenant that they had made with God when they were with Moses, when they had been brought out of the Exodus, when God gave them his law. After they heard the law, the people said, all the words the Lord has spoken, we will do. We agree, Lord. Yes, we will do these words. And they made a covenant with the Lord. And hence Moses took 12 stones. And so Elijah started by reaffirming the covenant that their father had made with the Lord. He didn't stop there. He told the people, get 4 jars of water. Remember, water was scarce then, because it hadn't rained 3.5 years, but he still said, 4 jars of water, pour it over the sacrifice. All over it. He told them to do this 3 times. And so water had filled all the area. there was a trench they had dug around that was all full of water. And so Elijah didn't show him how much he believes in his Lord and take away any notion of any trickery that might occur. And after he had done this, he called to the Lord, invoking him through the covenant, saying, O God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, let it be known this day that you are the God of Israel, and that I am your servant, and that I have done all these things at your word. Answer me, O Lord, that these people may know that you are, O Lord, the God, and that has turned their hearts back. This was his prayer. And then a top fire fell from the sky and consumed the burnt offering and the wood and the stones and the dust and licked up the water that was in the trench. There was nothing left. The Lord was pleased. And at the sight of that, the people's heart had turned to the Lord and they cried out as they fell on their faces saying, the Lord, he is God. The Lord, he is God. It was no coincidence that Elijah was called, and this happened at this occasion, because the very name of Elijah, Eliyah, means my God is Yah. My God is the Lord, Yah being the name of God. And this is all the people cried out. The Lord, he is God. Yah is God. This is the name that we have in the symbol, the emblem in our church, the Yud He, Yah. That is the name of the Lord. At these very contents, we see it was not so much Elijah versus Ahab, but it was Yah versus Baal. And so this Baal who had turned the hearts of many people away from the Lord was now silenced. It was shown to be an empty, a fake God that could do nothing. And really, Baal was an empty deity, which demons were hiding behind. This is what St. Paul says, that behind every idol is a demon. But here, the Lord had bound the demon. They could not say nothing, could not do nothing, but just watch as the Lord consumed that sacrifice during this showdown. Now, idolatry may seem like a foreign concept to us, beloved. We may say, we don't worship idols. We don't worship, you know, statues made of gold and wood like Israel did, or these fake deities. Well, perhaps we don't worship traditional idols like that. But have we made our own idols? Because really, an idol is anything that replaces God. To say anything in place of a son that we put in place. We remove God from his mission and we place something there to say, this is our Lord, this is our God. There may be many vows today, not just one. The worship of our body, the worship of technology, the worship of our work, the worship of commodities, the worship of many things, beloved. Blessings that the Lord has given us that we have taken and misappropriated and now using them to be as an idol for us. These need to be pulled down. They need to be broken. They need to be destroyed. And the altar of the Lord needs to be repaired. Just like in that day when Elijah challenged the Baal prophets. Through this season of summer, the church is inviting us to enter into our own repentance, where we endeavor to uproot the error of idols in our lives and repair the private altar of our heart, so that when we offer to the Lord, He will consume our offering. He will hear our prayers in our repentance. He will send us that fire from heaven, the Holy Spirit, that will give us keys, that we will know that the Lord has heard our prayers, and that we, with Elijah and Israel, may also cry out and say, "The Lord, He is God. The Lord, He is God." Glory be to His name. Amen. Before I pray the prayer of absolution, just want to let you know that we will continue to be offering these live stream services God willing. This coming Friday will be a commemoration of Saint James, or Saint Jacob of Nisibis, by the upper Nisibis. 7 p.m. will be live streaming this commemoration, and Bible studies is returning to Zoom for Tuesday nights for the youth. Wednesday nights, it's still happening, 7:30 p.m. You can find the details on our Facebook page. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, forever. Amen. O good God, full of mercy, O good God, full of mercy, whose grace and compassion are abundant upon all, pour in my God the kindness and pleasant lovely service of yours, and transform them in the hope of renewal to life and repentance. Renewing them in your Holy Spirit, by whom they are sealed for their salvation, and purifying them in kindness from the blemishes of the flesh and of the spirit. Strengthen the hope of their belief by the help of your grace. Make straight the gates of their deeds and the paths of righteousness. Make them to rejoice with the saints in the kingdom, in the confirmation of the hope of their faith, of the adoption of such and joy of the God of mysteries. Strengthen them by the aid of your mercy to observe your commandments, and to fulfill your will, to confess, worship, and glorify your holy name, the Lord of all, Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit, forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Peace be with us.
The grace of the Holy Spirit be with you and with us, and the partakers hereof, in the kingdom of heaven forever. Amen.
Amen. With you and with us, and with the partakers hereof, in the kingdom of heaven, praise you, the living God.
The gift of grace of Almighty the Lord Jesus Christ, the perfected mercy is with us all.
Church and be
commemoration of the 12 apostles and might also be blessed upon you. May you stay safe, keep holding the Lord, and we look forward to seeing you soon. God bless.